I feel like about 10 years older since the time I wrote the first album. It wasn't intended to be nastier. In fact, I think there are a lot of songs that have quite a funny side to them as well. Maybe there's some more humorous things coming out than on the first album, I think, for me personally. But I just think it sounds older, more worn in, worn out.
Britain's PJ Harvey, worn in and worn out after only two albums. But it's understandable when you consider how over the top both critics and fans were in response to their 1992 debut album called Dry. It seemed like music mags were tripping over themselves, singing PJ Harvey's praises, so much so that it resulted in a near burnout for Polly. So the band laid low for a summer, basically writing, putting together their second album, which they released last May. The first single off that album, which is called Rid of Me, was inspired by an old sci-fi film called Attack of the 50-Foot Woman. Maybe this is PJ Harvey's comeback energy. The single is called 50-Foot Queenie.
Really don't like to analyze your lyrics. I'm not going to do that. But I'm going to say I noticed the word lick a lot. Lick my legs, lick my injuries. And I thought, wow, Polly really likes this licking business. You can deal with that if you want.
Licking, yeah. I think I'm very into all of the senses, sniffing in particular, smell. I base a lot of judgment of people on what they smell like. Huge amount, and I like to smell things before I eat them, or smell things before I touch them, or if I like the feel of a piece of clothing, I want to smell it first. And not licking actually, but smelling. But I judge a lot on what people smell like. And if you're intimate with somebody, then you can judge quite a lot on what they taste like as well if you lick them. So
I just suddenly had this fear: did I put on my underarm deodorant today or not?
I was a very shy, introverted child, and I still am, I think. But you learn ways to adapt. You develop ways that make you look like you're not like that at all. Well, I still am. Feel very or lack confidence amongst other people, and still have a fear of crowds. And I remember the first times when I was growing up, I ever went into a city, and I was literally made myself ill from being so frightened amongst so many other people. Is something I wasn't used to. But I think if you suppress a lot of things in one direction, maybe I suppress a lot of things that I feel. If I feel angry, if I feel upset or hurt, I'm unable to communicate that to whoever it is that's doing that to me. And so instead it has to come out in another way, and the way I have for that is through music.
Consider yourself sexy?
No.
You don't?
No.
I'm so surprised to hear you say that.
I don't think I never, that's something else. I never feel confident in how I look, or I don't feel particularly sexy. I feel like quite a dog most of the time to look at.
Those eyes and that smile, I can't imagine you thinking that, but at the same time, then why are you exposing yourself in such a naked way?
Because I don't think I mind what people think about me, really. I only expose myself in ways like that because I think it helps the music or reflects what the music is doing, which is, again, very uninhibited, I suppose. Or just not worried about saying exactly what I feel. Because I really don't care what people think or say about me. Because as long as I know the reasons I'm doing it, or that I'm getting pleasure out of doing it, and I think it's saying the right things that I wanna get across, then it doesn't really matter. I'll measure time. I'll measure.
more comfortable in the company of men than women?
Yes, I do.
Why is that, you suppose?
Well, I always say I think it's because of how I grew up, which was there were no other girls in the village, and I just played with boys and ended up a tomboy until I was about 14. I don't know if that is the reason. I think all the bands I've ever been involved with have always been male. I've spent, since I was 18, I've been touring on and off with in different bands I've been with, which is always with men. All the tours that I've ever been on, all the crew are male. My band's always been male. It's what I'm used to, it's what I like.
You've written songs about sexual jealousy, like really heavy songs about sexual jealousy. And I wondered if you preferred the company of men because if you're around other women, you don't get all the attention.
Well, I think that you're probably right as well. I think that's got a huge part to do with it. That's not all the whole reason, but yeah, I think that's probably true. I wouldn't want another woman in my band. I want to be the only woman in my band.
Steve Albini, you know, he's got Nirvana's new album, he's, the Breeders and Pixies and everything. Is he a genius when it comes to just letting you do what you need to do?
Yeah.
That's what I've heard.
He's excellent. Wonderful man, intelligent, sensitive. He is a genius. But he has very high demands of you as well, and that's what I like. He expects you to know what you're doing and do it well and do it quickly, which is what I like. I don't like all this people looking after you too much and going, if you had enough time to do that, would you like to spend a little more time, you could get it perfect. He's not into that. He is into capturing the atmosphere of a song, getting the right feel to it, not playing something correctly again and again and again until you get it perfect. It's got nothing to do with what he's interested in or what I'm interested in. I've been reading a lot of Bukowski lately, which I find is really funny. It makes me laugh out loud reading a lot
Charles
of
Bukowski?
Stuff. Yeah.
Oh, Charles is always called the misogynist, Charles Bukowski.
Yeah, but I really enjoy his stuff.
What,
he's
really?
Me rolling around.
You never take offence?
No, it's great. What else?
But they call Steve Albini, your producer, the misogynist Steve Albini, too, because
maybe
of being
a rape. Maybe they should start calling me a misogynist, too.
Pardon me?
Maybe they should start calling me a misogynist as well.
I don't believe that.
Steve Albini is not a misogynist. No. He treats men and women exactly the same. He's just, if he doesn't like you, he'll let you know whether you're a man or a woman.
Isn't that true of you too?
Of me?
Yeah.
Well, I won't know. If I don't like somebody, I won't let them know. I'll probably be very nice to them.
Would you? Mm. So I can't tell from this conversation whether we're getting along or not?
No, you can't, but we are, and I do like you. But I can tell you that. You smell all right.
Oh, good.